Demand for COVID-19 testing continues to grow as Omicron sweeps across Minnesota and the nation. Yesterday, Governor Tim Walz announced that the state would be providing more resources, including 3 new community testing sites and at-home rapid test kits for families with children. But is there a better time to take a PCR test versus a rapid test? Kate Raddatz has the answer.
When tests are in high demand, is there a right kind of test to look for?
The right test is the one that you can get access to. And I know that's a little simplistic.
The FDA says rapid tests do detect Omicron, but may have reduced sensitivity.
They detect more of just the presence of high viral loads.
CentraCare COVID-19 Incident Commander Dr. George Morris says rapid antigen tests can have false negatives if there is not enough viral load yet present, but they're still useful. For example, if you're planning a gathering, you could take one rapid test a few days prior and another the morning of.
The antigen-based tests really look a lot and I think are better used for, am I contagious or not?
Experts say PCR tests work to detect if the coronavirus is present in the body, so people could test positive on a PCR test even if they're no longer contagious.
I had the exposures, but now 2 days later, I have a low-grade fever, I'm coughing.
Dr. Morris says if you suddenly have COVID symptoms and get a negative rapid test, you should still stay away from others and wear a mask and try testing with another test a couple of days later.
Tests are helpful to help you make a better decision, but it's not the only factor. Perhaps I work in an industry where I really need to be at work.
If you do get a positive on a rapid antigen test, Dr. Morris says there's no need to then take a PCR test. False positives are rare. Reporting in Chanhassen, Kate Raddatz, WCCO4 News.
Dr. Morris said because tests are in such limited supply right now, he is encouraging Minnesotans to not hoard the tests and only use them when necessary until supply improves.